growing up in Puerto Rico was a blessing.
He carries the musical bug in his genetic code.
I taught myself how to play the guitar. It was a process. My father taught me the first 2-3 chords. I highly emulated my father, who was my hero. He passes away when I was 14, and that's when I really got to it. You know, it was my connection to him somewhat and my way to heal. Even though I always gravitated towards music, it became something special. Culturally, we're very rich because of many factors. Our ancestors, the Africa is very present in us still. Our Indians, our Spaniards, our political situation drives us to be very proud of who we are, and we want to prove that we have an identity. So all of that was part of my growing up.
Pedro Capo is a guitarist, singer, and lyricist. He is the grandson of Puerto Rican legend Bobby Capo, an internationally acclaimed vocalist who was known for merging slow romantic music with classical sounds.
I was born knowing of his mystique, of this. He was this major artist, you know, that impacted the world, and I was just very curious, and I knew my father did it, and I was very close to my father, so I was like, oh, so Abuelo does this, Papi does this, maybe this is what I do as well. So, you know, I got to hang out with him mainly in hotel rooms when he was visiting, or in rehearsal rooms. Got to see him live in the last concert in Puerto Rico, so that was amazing. You know, what most have influenced me from him, besides his grandeur and being my grandfather, I would say, it was, you know, everybody tells me, and it's evident, his discipline and his respect for the craft. He would not leave room for mistakes, and that's something that I had somewhat incorporated into my way of pursuing music. Algo
quieres esconder. Pedro carries his family musical legacy with pride. During his trajectory to fame, he has earned numerous awards, including a Latin Grammy. He's written hit songs for other fellow artists, including Puerto Rico's Ricky Martin. Latin trap sensation Farruko and 15-time Grammy winner Alicia Keys have also fallen for Capo's hit-making knack, which ended in the remix of Pedro's latest single, Calma.
Shooting the video for Calma.
A song about disconnecting from the daily routine by going to the beach.
Calma wasn't a song that was written to be a single or to be a hit, you know? It was out of the joy of it. And Farruko connected with it. I didn't know him. He wrote to me on social media, and that's how it happened. And eventually I got to Alicia the same way, you know? She was in Tulum in Mexico at an eco house. And the person in charge of the house, or the hotel, became friends with them, was showing the music, and one of the songs he showed them was mine. And they, you know, were curious about it, then they kept listening to it, hearing it all over the beach that weekend, because the song was doing well over there. So he kept asking about it, and he's like, listen, you know, we know people from Sony, so if you want to do it. So that's the way it happened. I'm still blown away by all of those opportunities, you know. I feel like there's something very interesting happening in music in general. It says a lot when the major sounds are accomplished by things that are not necessarily English, you know, so it's...
As he gets ready to go on stage at the Howard Theater, one of Washington, D.C.'s oldest, Capo reflects on Puerto Rico's musical heritage and his own professional development, which extends nearly two decades.
Cuando sientes que el miedo te arropa, mi amor, cuando el llanto te oprima y no consigas tranquilidad, no dudes aquí no estás. Y cuando no haya respuestas y la preocupación.
There's an X factor that I can't even, I don't know, you know, we're so small and we do have, you know, a big number of artists that have touched the whole music world beyond Spanish, you know, Latin music. So kids were moving to New York in the 40s by masses. And they would listen to new songs, and then they would come back and kind of bring it. So we had that freshness about the sounds getting there first. And I feel like our geographical position as well has a lot to do with it. We got the States, we got Mexico, we're kind of the bridge in the Americas, so it definitely has to do. But I mean, something our grandmothers are putting in the rice and beans, I don't know, it's quite special, you know? The array of music that we have, from our salsa and Latin ballads and bomba plena, all the traditional sounds, plus what we have from the influence that everybody has, you know, the Anglo stuff and the big world hits have somewhat influenced my life, so it's been a process.